Certainly, we're all very pleased to have that tribute done, not only to the Irish of the city, but to Dave Burke, who founded that collection back about 45 years ago. Today, we're going to close it with a great concert. We have Terry Kelly, our pianist. And Bill Donlin, who's going to be the soloist today. If you haven't heard them in the past, you're in for a treat. And if you have, that's why you've returned, because they are very good. So we thank you for coming. We thank the cable TV for televising this, taping and televising this event. We're very pleased with that. They take most of our events over Irish Heritage Month. We also want to thank the library for the use of these great facilities. It's a beautiful library. It's a hidden gem in the city. We want to thank the city officials who came today to today's events. And at the same time, we have to mention, we want to thank many of these events happen because of Lawrence Cultural Council. We want to thank them for the support. We appreciate that. Enjoy, and if you haven't, there are refreshments in the back. Please enjoy them. There's plenty more. Have a great afternoon.
Thank you.
Ready when you are. Yeah, okay, go ahead. Yeah. Sure, if I had the wings of a swallow, I would travel far over the sea. Then a rocky old road I would follow to a spot that is heaven to me. When the sun goes to rest way down in the west, then I'll build such a nest in the place I love best. In that dear little town in the Owl County Down, it will linger way down in my heart. Though it never was grand, sure it's my fairy land, just a wonderful world set apart. Oh, my Ireland of dreams, you are with me, it seems, and I care not for fame or renown. Like the black sheep of old, I'll come back to the fold. Little town in the Owl County Down. In the evening when shadows are fallen round the old door without any key, there's a voice in me heart ever calling. There are eyes ever watching for me. There is someone I've left with true tenderness, and her lips I'll caress when I bring happiness. To that dear little town in the Owl County Down, it will linger way down in my heart. Though it never was grand, sure it's my fairy land, just a wonderful world set apart. Oh, my Ireland. land of dreams, you are with me, it seems. And I care not for fame or renown. Like the black sheep of old, I'll come back to the fold. Little town in the old county down.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here today. We want to thank the Lawrence Library friends and the Ancient Order of Hibernians for sponsoring us. This is our fifth or sixth concert, I think. We took a couple years off for COVID, like everything, and everything cultural sort of disappeared, but we're glad to be back, and we've got some great songs for you today. We're going to be singing and playing some Irish music. You'll get to hear songs that range over a couple of centuries of Irish music. The next song is called The Meeting of the Waters, and there's a town in Ireland where two rivers come together, and they each have a different color. One is kind of a muddy river, and the other one is very clear. And at this particular town, they meet and blend, and it's always been seen as kind of a synonym for the Protestant and the Irish blending together for one Ireland. The song is called The Meeting of the Waters.
There is not in this wide world a valley so sweet as that vale in whose bosom the bright waters meet. Oh, the last rays of feeling and life must depart ere the bloom of that valley shall fade from my heart. Ere the bloom of that valley shall fade from my heart. Yet it was not that nature had shed o'er the scene her purest of crystal and brightest of greens. 'Twas not her soft magic of streamlet or a hill. Oh no, it was something more exquisite still. Oh no, it was something more exquisite still. 'Twas that friends, the beloved of my bosom, were near, who made every bright scene of enchantment more dear, and who felt how the best charms of nature improve when we see them reflected in looks that we love, when we see them reflected in looks that we love. Sweet veil of Avoca, how calm could I rest in thy bosom of shade with the friends I love best, where the storms that we feel in this cold world should cease, and our hearts, like thy waters, be mingled in peace, and our hearts, like thy waters, be mingled in a peace.
Thank you. Derek, do you know the background of this, Carrick Fergus? Do you know the background of the song? Okay, this is a song called Carrick Fergus, which is a town in Ireland. And it's a typical love song and sorrow for having left the Emerald Isle. So it kind of combines it into one song. So let's sing Carrick Fergus.
Oh, I have one thing to say.
Okay. Do you want to use this?
There's a song called Oh Wally Wally.
Oh,
and
yes.
There's a song called The River Is Wide. And they have kind of the same tune, same melody. So they're similar. So we're going to do Carrick Fergus, and then I'll do the other one, and you can see how they kind of belong together. The river stories.
Yes. I were in Carrick Fergus only for nights in Ballygran. I would swim over the deepest ocean, the deepest ocean, for my love to find. For the sea is wide, and I cannot swim over, and neither have I wings to fly. If I could find me a handsome boatman to carry me over to my love and die. My childhood days bring back reflections of happy times I spent long ago. My childhood friends and my relations have all passed on now like melting snow. I'll spend my days in endless roaming. Soft is the grass, my bed is free. Back now in Carrick Fergus on that long road down to the sea. Gonna play a Wally. There's a song, many of the Irish songs are, especially the older ones, they're songs of loss. It's the immigrant crying out for his native land, her native land, that they miss, all the friends and family left behind. And particularly a town in the early 20th century, before Ireland was an independent nation, it was longing for freedom from the British, who they felt, the Irish had felt, had oppressed their island for centuries. And the best example of that is, of course, the Great Famine, where million upon millions of Irish either emigrated or starved under British policies. So this song is actually of that family. It's called Only Our Rivers Run Free. It's not really applicable to today's Ireland. Today's Ireland is exceptionally prosperous, I'm happy to say. And they actually have a higher per capita income than the United States. It's higher than every country except for 8 countries in the world. So Ireland is very, very economically healthy, as opposed to a couple hundred years ago, when many of our ancestors came over fleeing the starvation of the great potato famine. So the song is called Only Our Rivers Run Free. When apples still grow in November, when blossoms still bloom from each tree, when leaves are still green in December, it's then that our land will be free. I've wandered her hills and her valleys, and still through her sorrow I see a land that has never known freedom, and only our rivers run free. How sweet is life, but we're crying. How mellow the wine, but we're dry. How fragrant the rose, but it's dying. How gentle the wind, but it sighs. What good is in youth when it's aging? What joy is in eyes that can't see? When there's sorrow in sunshine and flowers, and still only our rivers run free. So that's a good example of a typical Irish song, I'd say. A little melancholy, a little hopeful, involves love of the land, and the lyrics are very poetic. Most of these songs are very poetic, and the closer you listen to the words, I think the more you get out of the song, because they're a nice combination of words, poetry, and music. They're well done, they're well crafted, so that the two of them amplify the message very nicely. Now, this is not just an Irish festival, because you can't possibly sing Celtic music without involving Scottish music. The two genres developed in parallel for many centuries, and of course, Gaelic is spoken by the Scottish, the Irish, and the Welsh. The Welsh have the kind of their own language too, but it's heavily influenced by Gaelic. So there's a lot of wonderful Scottish music and Irish music where you can't tell who originally came up with it. You know, it was lost in the mists of time. But here's a song. This is an old song about King Charles Edward Stuart, whom they call the Young Pretender. He was a king of Scotland Scotland was an independent kingdom for many years, and the British, of course, took over the Scotland. And Charles Edward Stuart was one of the last kings of Scotland, and this this song commemorates a battle that was held between the Scottish and the British sometime in the 16th century. It's called the Skye Boat Song. Bonnie boat, like a bird on the wing, onward the sailors cry. Carry the lad that's born to be king over the sea to Skye. Loud the winds howl, loud the waves roar, thunder clouds rend the air. Baffled our foes stood on the shore, follow they would not dare. Though the waves leap, soft shall ye sleep, oceans of royal bed. Rocked in the deep, Flora will keep watch o'er your weary head. Many's the lad fought on that day, will the claymore could wield. When the night came, silently lay dead on Culloden's field. Burned are our homes, exile and death, scatter the loyal men. Yet o'er the sword, cool in the sheath, Charlie will come again. Speed, bonny boat, like a bird on the wing, onward the sailors cry. Carry the lad that's born to be king over the sea to Skye. Thank you. Here's a very traditional song. It's actually associated with summer, but as you'll see, it's about a lot more than summer. It's called The Last Rose of Summer.
Tis the last rose of the summer, left blooming all alone. All her lovely companions are faded and gone. No flower of her kindred, no rosebud is nigh. To reflect back her blushes and give sigh for sigh. So soon may I follow, when friends and ships decay, and from love's shining circle the gems drop away. When true hearts lie withered and fond ones have flown, oh, who would inhabit that bleak world alone?
Thank you. So far we've done mostly slow ballads. There's all kinds of Irish music, a lot of peppy stuff. And we want to sing a toe tapper for you now. It's called Black Velvet Band. Anybody know that song? Black Velvet Band? I think you're gonna enjoy it.
As I went walking one morning, not intending to stay very long, I met with a frolicsome damsel as she came skipping along. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds, you'd think she was queen of the land, and her hair thrown over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. Her watch she pulled out of her pocket and slapped it right into my hand. On the very first day that I met her, bad luck to the black velvet band. Before the judge and the jury, the both of us had to appear. A gentleman claimed his jewelry, the case against us was quite clear. For 7 long years transportation, right down to Van Diemen's land. Far away from me friends and relations, betrayed by the black velvet band. So come all ye jolly young fellows, take a warning by me in this song. Whenever you're on your liquor, me lads, beware of the pretty Colleen's. She'll fill you with whiskey and porter until you're unable to stand. And the very next thing that you know, lads, you've landed in Van Diemen's land.
Van Diemen's land is Tasmania. It was a prison colony, an island off the coast of Australia, where many Irish and English Irish were transported for the most tiny crimes. You could steal a cup of rice and get 7 years in a prison colony in Australia. So there are many, many Irish people in Australia, Irish ethnic people in Australia. Many of them came from the transportation to the prison colony there. Now the next song is one of my favorites. I see some familiar faces here, but I always like to mention John McCormick. Any of you know of John McCormick, the famous Irish tenor? Just a tremendous singer. And my mother was one of 11. Her name was Sullivan. And so Bill and I are related. Her mother was from a place in Ireland called Tralee. And this is near where this song takes place. Is on this southeastern part of Ireland. It's kind of a spooky song. It's called "She Moved Through the Fair."
It's very spooky.
It's very spooky. Take it from Terry. She'll play it very spooky for you.
Young love said to me, my mother, won't mind, and me father won't slight you for your lack of kind. Then she stepped away from me, and this did she say: "It will not be long, love, till our wedding day." The people were saying that no two e'er were wed, but one had a sorrow that never was said. So I smiled as she passed with her goods and her gear, and that was the last that I saw of my dear. I dreamt it last night that my dead love came in. So softly she came that her feet made no din. She came close beside me, and this did she say: "It will not be long, love, till our wedding day."
I have never been to Ireland yet. I definitely intend to go. But I do look up, when I sing these songs, I look up their history, and I try to look up a little bit about the area that the songs are describing. So in the northeast corner of Ireland is an area that people tell me is one of the more traditional areas of the nation. And there's still a healthy belief in fairies and tinkers and things like that. And this song is about an unfortunate man who took a shortcut through that part of the country and had an unexpected occurrence.
I'm going to say something.
Oh, sure.
There's a lot of information about fairies in Ireland. Some are good and some are bad. But the fairies occurred when you were in a state of altered consciousness, let's say. So some people suffering with a psychiatric condition would see fairies. But there was a fountain in Ireland that was called the Magic Fountain. And years later, after they found out why people were being cured of their mental delusions, he found out that the fountain was loaded with lithium, which is the treatment for schizophrenia, manic depressive illness. So some of the fountains would make you see fairies, and some of the fountains would make them go away. And there were good fairies and there were bad fairies. So the good fairies were fun, and there were many stories about them, right, to entertain the children as they went through the troubles and all this. But there were also bad fairies, and one is called the Banshee. So how many of you have heard of the Banshee? Everyone, right? Well, my friend's grandmother used to say, "Run him, no," or "the Banshee or the Aftir." And I didn't know what she meant, but I ran home anyway. And my Italian mother used to say, "Comb that hair, you look like a banshee." So the banshee is pretty well known. I've never seen a real one, but I'm still kind of afraid of her. Here.
Thank you. I'll drink a little lithium water to get me in the mood for the song. By By the shortcut to the Rosses, a fairy girl I met. I was taken by her beauty as the fish is in the net. The fern uncurled to look at her, so very fair was she, with her hair as bright as the seaweed that floats in from the sea. By the shortcut to the Rosses, 'twas on the 1st of May, I heard the fairies piping, and they piped me heart away. They piped till I was mad with joy, but when I was alone, I found me heart was piped away, and in me breast a stone. By the shortcut to the Rosses, 'tis I'll go nevermore, lest she should steal me soul, like she stole me heart before. Like she take me soul and crush it like a dead leaf in her hand. For the shortcut to the Rosses is the road to fairyland. Thank you. The next song I'm going to sing is set in Northern Ireland, in County Antrim, which is up on the northeast corner of Ireland, of Northern Ireland, of the Irish. The Irish Republic is regular Ireland. I don't know what the Northern Irish call themselves, but it's the part that's still part of the United Kingdom. And it's a lovely town. I haven't been there, but I've seen a lot of pictures of it, and it's right on the ocean, and right outside of the town is a 1,200 foot tall tabletop mound. It's a flat mountain that rises up. It looks like a volcano without the top of it. And I guess it's a beautiful view from the top. You can see parts of the United Kingdom on a nice day. And this song is called The Green Glens of Antrim. Lies a true paradise, with the sea rippling over the shingles and sand, where the gay honeysuckle is luring the bee, and the green glens of Antrim are calling to me. Imagine the picture of heaven it would be, where the green glens of Antrim are calling to me. Sure, I hope to return to my own Cushendall. 'Tis the one place I know that can outshine them all. Sure, I know every stone, I recall every tree, where the green glens of Antrim are calling to me. And if only you knew how the light of the moon turns a blue Irish bay to a silver lagoon. You'd imagine a picture of heaven it would be, where the green glens of Antrim are calling to me. Terry has something. She's going to, it's a surprise to me, so she's going to surprise us all.
I thought you should have a surprise once in a while, because we always know what we're going to do.
Yes.
Most of the time.
Yeah. Want me to hold one end?
Yeah. Can you read this fellow's name? Can you read this fellow's name? I need help.
It's the first
name?
It's
his name. Yeah. Give up. It's Torlo O'Carolan.
Oh, look at that.
Torlo O'Carolan. That's a few extra letters in his name.
Yeah.
But then my name is Kelly, and the old me is K. No, but the old me is U I. With a little something or other over the U to make it say O. O. And then it's K-E-I-L-L-A-I-G-H. Pronounced Kelly, of course. So this is...
They must have been paid by the letter.
This is Torlo O'Carolan. And he was called the Blind Harper. He was blinded by smallpox when he was little. He was born in 1670, and I think he died in 1784 or something like that, but he lived a long time ago, and he wrote some beautiful music. He also was a poet, and he's mostly known for his music, but I'm going to read one of his poems, but first I have to tell you what it's about. When he was old and ready to pass away, his doctor told him, no alcohol, not even one sip. So he got a different doctor. And that doctor said, I think a sip of alcohol once in a while would be good for you. So he wrote a poem on his deathbed, and he dedicated it to Glidden, his butler, because his butler brought him his last drink. And he was unable to take a sip from the glass because he was too weak. So what he did was wave it goodbye. He gave it a kiss, and he said, goodbye, my friend. And then he passed away in comfort. And so this is a poem that he wrote about that.
Sure. What a way to go.
His last sip. Okay.
He's a fool who'd give over the liquor. It softens the skin flint at once. It urges the slow coach on quicker, gives spirit and brains to the dunce. A man who is quiet as a rule discovers a great deal to say, while he who has been bashful since Yule will talk in an amorous way. It's drink that uplifts the poltroon to give battle in France and in Spain. Now here is an end of my turn, and fill me that bumper again.
Quote unquote, Irish music has been written on many continents. Of course, the primary source is Ireland itself, but there's a very large Celtic diaspora, Irish people and Scottish and Celtic people all over the world, and many, many countries have an active Irish music community and very appreciative fans in that country as well. The next song I'm going to sing was written by a local person named Jerry McCall. He was from Methuen?
McCall.
Yeah, Jerry McCall. Was he from Methuen?
Yes.
Yeah. He wrote this song, and did he give it to you, Terry? Were you the first one who presented it?
Yeah.
So Terry introduced this song to me. I like it very much, and so we'd like to sing it for you right now. It's called The First Rose of Killarney. Let me tell you all a story that's become a part of me. 'Twas the sweetest thing that
that happened since I crossed the Irish Sea. On my way to meet my darling, oh, the angels took my hand and they led me to the one rose in all of Ireland. First I spied it as I wandered down the lakes near old Killarney, like a vision of my sweetheart with her lips so red and rare. 'Twas the first rose of Killarney, sure, and God had placed it there. So I picked it for my darling and I placed it in her
hair. Okay, here's probably one of the darker songs that we're going to sing today. Someone called Terry, maybe they're here, and requested that we sing this song at today's concert. The song is about the Troubles, and particularly Derry in Northern Ireland. It's about a boy's recollection of his childhood there and how he misses the town. It's called The Town I Love So Well. In my memory, I will always see the town that I have loved so well, where our school played ball by the gas yard wall, going home through the smoke and the smell. Running home in the rain, up and down the dark lane, past the wall and down behind the fountain. Those were happy days in so many, many ways in the town I loved so well. In the early morn, the shirt factory horn called the women from Craigan, the moor and the bog, while the men on the dole played a mother's role, took the children and then walked the dog. And when times were tough, there was just about enough, but they saw it through without complaining. For deep inside was a burning pride in the town I loved so well. There was music there in the Derry air, like a language that we could all understand. I remember the day when I earned my first play, when I played in a small pickup band. There I spent my youth,
to tell you the truth, I was sad to leave it all behind me. For I'd learned about life, and I'd found me a wife in the town I loved so well. But when I returned, oh, my eyes, how they burned to see how a town could be brought to its knees, and the gas that hangs onto every breeze, but the armored cows and bombed out bars. Now the army's installed by the old gas yard wall, and their damned barbed wire gets higher and higher. With their tanks and their guns, oh my God, what have they done to the town I loved so well? Now the music's gone, but they still carry on, for their spirit's been bruised, never broken. They will never forget, but their hearts are set on tomorrow and peace once again. For what's done is done, and what's won is won, and what's lost is lost and gone forever. I can only pray for a bright, brand new day in the town I loved so well.
Thank you. Okay, we got two more songs, so we're going to go a little bit over today, but we'll try to get you out of here. The next song has been set to different lyrics many times. I can think of four different versions of this song just myself, and I don't know them all, I'm sure. The song is the London Derriere, which of course is best known as Danny Boy, but we're not going to sing the Danny Boy lyrics today. We're going to sing some different lyrics. I think they're just as effective, honestly. They have the same emotion and pathos that I think the Danny Boy song does. I've heard this song sung at funerals with one set of lyrics. I've heard it sung to lyrics that start with Mary Dear, which I think is a kind of a goofy arrangement that's kind of corny. And this song here, these lyrics are called Acushla Mine. And you'll see the tune is Danny Boy, but the lyrics are different and I think they're quite nice, so I hope you enjoy them. Acushla Mine, the singing birds are calling, the call of love that's meant for lovers true. 'Tis autumn time, and where the leaves are falling, alone I wait to beg a word with you. 'Tis of my love I would be pleading. Around my heart your fingers you entwine. The birds above know how much I am needing one little word to bid me hope. Acushla Mine, Acushla Mine, when birds again are singing their mating song and all the land is gay, when at the church the wedding bells are ringing,
above or lean tear, 'twill be a happy day. And through the years, no matter what the weather, around my heart, your love it will entwine. We'll wander on as long as we're together, and wander into
Terry's gonna, another surprise, Terry's gonna play a song by Tommy Makem, which is good because our last song has a Tommy Makem connection, and I'll let her introduce this song and then I'll talk about our last song.
Okay.
This is called Song for the Children. The notes are way up high. Way up here. Kind of hard to reach.
Too high for me.
I can't even squeak from home. What it's about is he's walking along in the springtime and he's admiring the beautiful weather and the sunshine and everything. And then he says, what kind of land will we leave to our children? What will their legacy be? Will the water be pure? Are we taking care of things well enough? So this was written quite a while ago, right? But it's about climate change and all this stuff. A little bit before his time. But it's called Song for the Children.
Thank you.
Song of Hope.
Surprising you again. It's full of surprises today. Okay, our last song has a connection with Tommy Makem. Tommy Makem was one of he wasn't the Clancy brother. He was part of the group The Clancy Brothers and Tommy Makem, which if you grew up in the 60s or 70s in America and you were Irish American, you probably had some of their records in your house. I know we did in my house. And Tommy Makem was not a brother, but he was an Irish musician, came from the north of Ireland, and he moved over to the States, believe it or not. He lived in Derry, New Hampshire, of all places. And he lived out probably his last third of his life in Derry, died in Derry, and was buried in Derry, New Hampshire. He adopted America as his second country. And he wrote this song, I didn't know until I did some research on it. The words are by no less a luminary than William Butler Yeats, the great Irish poet, playwright. And the words come from a speech that one of his characters gives in a play, I forget the name of the play, but the song is called The Parting Glass, and the Clancy Brothers would often close their live programs with this song. You'll see why, I think, when I sing it for you. I spent it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass, good night and joy be with you all. Oh, of all the comrades that e'er I've known, they are sorry for my going away, and all the sweethearts that e'er I've had, they would wish me one more day to stay. But since it falls unto my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and I'll softly call, good night and joy be with you all. But since it falls unto my lot that I should die and you should not, I'll gently rise and I'll softly call, good night and joy be with you all.
Thank you.